Everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Meenakshi and I am doing a video series on the Indian Contract Act 1872. In our previous classes, we discussed about the history and background of the Indian Contract Act 1872, how it came into force, what all provisions are there in the Indian Contract Act, and what each of the chapters in Indian Contract Act talks about. In today's discussion, we will move ahead with the difference between a contract and an agreement. We all know that the Indian Contract Act deals with the rules or laws that would be applicable in case two or more parties enter into any form of a contract. But before moving ahead with the provisions and what all rules or laws would be applicable, we should know what a contract is. So, the Indian Contract Act 1872 provides for definition of various terms that are being used under the statute. Under section 2, you can see various definitions of different terms are being provided. So, today we will be discussing three of the important definitions provided under the Indian Contract Act. And then we will move ahead with the difference between a contract and an agreement. The first definition that we will discuss today is Section 2E of the Indian Contract Act that provides for a definition of the term agreement. As per Section 2E of the Indian Contract Act, every promise and every set of promises forming consideration for each other is an agreement. That means what it may be. Agreement may be one single promise or a set of promises. For example, one person agrees to go out for a movie with someone else. That is one single promise that the person makes. That may be an agreement. If the person says, I will go out for a movie with you, I will buy tickets for that movie, I will pick you up from your place, and after the movie, I will also drop you to the place where you want. That means what? It is a set of promises that the person is making. So that also would be an agreement. In case of an agreement, it may be one single promise or it may be a set of different promises that the person is making. So, as per Section 2E of the Indian Contract Act, an agreement, what is an agreement? It means one single promise or a set of promises forming consideration for each other. That means what? Only it is not depending on only one person. Only A cannot say that I am willing to go out for a movie with you. B also has to agree to that. So then it would become an agreement. One person saying something, the other person also accepting to that. It would become an agreement as per the definition provided under Section 2E of the Indian Contract Act. The next definition that we will discuss today is Section 2G of the Indian Contract Act. Section 2G of the Indian Contract Act provides for definition of void agreement. It says an agreement not enforceable by law is said to be void. That means what? Two persons have made an agreement. That agreement may not be enforceable in the court of law. In case the agreement is not enforceable in the court of law, it would be considered as void. Void means that particular agreement would become invalid. We cannot approach the court for violation of that particular agreement. For example, A agrees to go out for a movie with B, but something happens. A is not able to go out for a movie on that particular day. B cannot go to the court and file a case for that simple reason. So that means those kinds of agreements are void agreements. Why? Because for violation of those agreements, we cannot approach the court. Why? Because those are agreements of social nature. We enter into such agreements on a daily basis. For example, accepting a dinner invitation. That also is an agreement, but we cannot approach the court in case the other person refuses to come on that particular day. Even though we have prepared food and everything, we cannot go to the court for violation of those agreements. So, any agreement or any promise made by one person to the other which is not enforceable in the court of law would be considered as a void agreement. That means it would be invalid in the eyes of law. Next definition that is provided under Indian Contract Act is the definition of the term contract. It is provided under Section 2H of the Indian Contract Act. So, according to 2H of the Indian Contract Act, contract is an agreement enforceable by law. That means any promise entered into between two or more parties for violation of which we can approach the court is a contract. That means agreement whereby for violation of which we can approach the court would be considered as contract. So, after reading these three definitions, agreement, void agreement and a contract, we know that agreements are of two types. What are these two types? These are agreements enforceable by law and agreements which are not enforceable by law. So, in case the agreement is enforceable by law, it would be considered as a contract. In case it is not enforceable by law, it would be considered as a void agreement. Now, this part is clear that agreement, what is an agreement? Any sort of promise or a set of promises between two or more persons. In case the agreement is enforceable in law, it would be a contract. In case it is not enforceable in the court of law, it would be considered as a void agreement. We cannot approach the court for violation of void agreements, but we can rightfully approach the court of law for violation of a contract. That means any agreement which is enforceable in the eyes of law. Now, moving to the difference between a contract and an agreement. What is an agreement? Agreement means offer and its acceptance constitute an agreement. That means offer plus acceptance would equal to an agreement. One person making an offer that I am willing to go out for a movie with you and the other person accepting that. That means offer and acceptance would make it an agreement. But what is a contract? It is agreement and its enforceability constitute a contract. That means agreement and enforceability would make it a contract. One person says, I want to go out for a movie with you. The other person accepts to that and they make an agreement. That agreement, if it is enforceable, then it would become a contract. For example, one person says, I am willing to supply raw materials for your factory for 10,000 rupees per month. The other person also accepts that. That I am willing to accept raw materials from you for 10,000 rupees every single month for my factory. That means there is an agreement and it is enforceable in the court of law. That means agreement and its enforceability will make it a contract. The second difference between an agreement and a contract is every agreement may not be a contract, but all contracts are agreements. That means what? All the agreements that we have, those agreements may not be enforceable. For example, accepting a dinner invitation, accepting a proposal to go out for a movie, those kinds of agreements are not enforceable by law. But those are agreements. So, every agreement may not be a contract. There may be some agreements which are void agreements. But in case of contract, what happens? All contracts are agreements. Because for a contract, we need an agreement and its enforceability. So, all contracts are agreements, but all agreements may not be contracts. Some of them would be void agreements. The next difference is an agreement may not create legal obligation, but a contract necessarily creates legal obligation. An agreement may not be legally binding. Why? Because one person accepting a dinner invitation and then refusing it at a later moment, we cannot approach the court for violation of that. Some of the agreements are not enforceable in the court of law. But in case of contracts, we can for sure approach the court of law for any violation of the contractual obligations. The last difference is agreement is not concluded or a binding contract in all cases, but contract is concluded and binding on the concerned parties. So in case of agreements, it may not be binding on the parties. It may not be creating some sort of a legal relationship between two of the parties. But in case of a contract, it for sure creates a legal relationship and it would be binding on the parties. For any violation of the contractual obligations, parties will have to face the consequences. Now, these are the differences between an agreement and a contract. So, we know that all agreements may not be contracts, but all contracts are agreements. But when we say that agreements may not be enforceable in the court of law, they might be a void agreement, we only mean that it is not enforceable in the court of law. But within our own means, we can definitely try to convince the other person to fulfill his contractual obligations. For example, A agrees to go out for a movie with B. Based on A's promise, B has already booked tickets and everything. He has made all the preparations, he has made every single thing that he had to do. Later on, at any moment, A comes and says that he is not willing to go out for a movie with B. At that moment, B cannot approach the court of law, saying that it is a violation of the promise that has been made by A. But what B can do is, within his own means, B can try to convince A that I have already booked the tickets for the movie, so maybe you should come for the movie, and whatever you have to do, you can do it at the later stage also. So within his own means, the person is still entitled to convince the other person from fulfilling his contractual obligations. The only thing is that the person cannot approach the court for violation of the contractual obligations or for enforcement of the contractual duties. But within his own means, he can still try to convince the other person from fulfilling his duties or liabilities. So this is the main difference between a contract and an agreement. That a contract is enforceable in the court of law, contract is creating some legal obligations on the parties for a violation of a contract, we can approach the court. And all contracts are agreements. So this is the main difference between a contract and an agreement. We will continue with offer and counter offer in the next class. Thank you so much for watching this video. Bye-bye.